Many times we see that our Windows computer or laptop is operating very slow. Its response time has increased a lot, and whenever we open any application, it opens after a long time. For instance, if we open any application or photos or browse the web, such actions taking 10 to 20 seconds instead of executing the operation immediately. The general troubleshooting method that we have been taught, like restart the machine, scanning for virus or malware, disk cleanup, deleting temporary files and cache, doing Windows update, and lots more. Even after trying them all, problem remains the same and the computer does not respond as quick as it is supposed to be. It's most likely due to high disk usage. Extreme disk usage slows down and frees our Windows computer, and it cannot do its job properly. In today's video, we are going to see how easily we can get rid of 100% disk usage problem. So let's crack the Windows. First of all, we are going to open the task manager and take a look at our disk usage. Right click on the taskbar and click on task manager. Now click on more details. In the processes tab, look at the disk process. Disk showing 100% usage. One thing I want to mention, this video is mainly to solve 100% disk usage problem. If you do not see 100% disk usage in the task manager, then it means computer is slow due to some other reason. And if so, then for general troubleshooting and speed up your computer, don't forget to watch the video how to speed up computer and laptop in just 5 minutes, whose link is also coming in the I button above. Now please follow the steps as I am showing. It is very important to watch the full video, as if you miss a single step, then the problem will not be solved. So please make sure to watch the video till end. First, we'll run a system file checker to verify the integrity of Windows system files and making sure there is no corrupt files in our Windows system. We need to open the command prompt with administrative privilege. Go to search bar and type cmd. Now right click on the command prompt and select run as administrator. Now type each command as it is, one by one, as I am doing, and wait until scan is completed. I had also written commands in the description too, so you can copy and paste them accordingly. First of all, we'll execute the command sfc /scannow. This command will scan all protected system files and replace corrupted files with a cached copy that is located in a compressed folder in Windows directory. Don't close this command prompt window until the verification is 100% complete. It will take approx 10 to 15 minutes. This process will perform scan of any corrupted system files for integrity violation and will attempt to repair it along with the Windows image. Now next, the DISM command should be executed in same order as I am doing. First command would be DISM /online /cleanup -image /CheckHealth. DISM stands for Deployment Image Servicing and Management. The CheckHealth option with the DISM command permits you quickly verify if there are any corruptions within the local Windows 10 image. However, this option does not perform any repairs. After the verification is complete, we will type DISM /online /cleanup -image /scanHealth. This DISM option performs a more complex scan to verify if the OS image has any trouble. This may take several minutes to check and verify whether the Windows 10 image needs fixing or not. After the verification completes, we have to type last DISM command, that is DISM /online /cleanup -image /RestoreHealth. DISM with the RestoreHealth option will scan and repair widespread issues automatically. While the command is running, it's expected to see the process stuck in the middle, like at 30% or 50-60%. But don't worry, after the few minutes, the process will complete successfully on its own. If you face any trouble in executing any of these commands, then definitely comment me below. I'll reply to your every comment and suggest best solution. The Deployment Image Servicing and Management tool will link up to the Windows Update servers to download and replace any damaged files in the local image for Windows 10 as necessary. After the scan completes, we'll check for available updates on our computer. We'll go to search bar and then type update. Click on the check for updates option and wait till system updates completely. One important thing, to do all these steps, it is very important to have the system online. Now restart the machine, and finally one more step needs to perform, that is clean boot. Go to search bar and type msconfig. System configuration utility box will open and by default you are on the general tab. Click on selective startup and make sure that load system service and load startup items both have checked mark. Now click on services tab. Put a check mark on hide all Microsoft services. This is very crucial part, as if you miss to click on this, the computer might not boot correctly and will end up with fresh installation only. Once hide all Microsoft services have check mark on it, click on disable all. Clean boot process will eliminate third party applications running in the background of your computer along with the services that are not needed to run Windows. If there is any conflicting third party application that causes the problem on your computer, this method will stop that. Now click on the startup tab and click open task manager. This will open a new window which contains all your startup applications. Disable all applications that you are not using. You can just click on them and select disable. Click OK. Apply and close the configuration utility. Restart the computer again. Now we'll check what is the status of our disk usage. When the computer restarts, then for 5 to 10 minutes, the disk usage is more, as the computer is loading a lot of applications. But even after some time, if you see 100% disk usage, then there must be a big problem in the system and you have to action on it. If the problem is still not solved, then the last option left with us is to replace our hard drive with SSD. SSD stands for solid state drives. SSDs significantly diminish access time since users don't have to wait for platter spin to start up. SSDs outperform HDDs as they use electrical circuitry and have no physical moving parts. This leads to shorter wait times when you are starting up and fewer interruptions when opening apps and doing hefty computing tasks. These faster speeds lead to performance advantages in several areas, such as when logging in and waiting for apps and services to start up, or when achieving storage intensive tasks. If the video helped you a little bit, then do like the video and subscribe the channel for the latest updates. That's all for today's video. Goodbye.